Raquel, ahead for Carter. He'll rim it around. Eller gets to it, shuffles it to Letang, who has space. Letang with a shot knocked down, and Brook rebounds loose, and it's knocked away by the pad of Sorokin. Skates in, dumps to the corner, down after it is Bo Horvat. Horvat to Barzell. He opens up in front, got a shot off the pad of Jari, back to the front, and Lee moved it over to the corner as he was trying to get it around Letang. Stick in a little too much, poked away by O'Connor. He's off ice. Thompson to beat, he'll take it wide. Now to the front, got crossed up. Sorokin stopped it, it's still loose. Wonder, Butch, where he'd be if it weren't for the concussion-related injuries back in 2011, 2012. He missed a lot of time. His numbers are impressive already, but if he hadn't missed a lot of games those two seasons, even more impressive. Pedersen shot blocked. They blew it dead before puck got past Sorokin.
Yeah, a good break there. And well, Sidney, if you were talking about the concussion and the missing the games, he'd be further down the list.
When the whistle blows, the place is most certainly dead. Hear the whistle long before.
Yeah. You could hear it there. Raquel, no doubt, put it in, but yeah, you definitely hear the whistle ahead.
And you can
of
tell his reaction. Look at Raquel's reactions, telling you.
Barzell looking for a way out, not successful. And here's Achari again. Lowers the shoulder, spins away from Barzell. The line, Pedersen across for Letang. The front, this one is redirected in. The Penguins have a 2-0 lead on a Jake Guentzel deflection.
Yeah, great deflection there as Letang fired it. That was about 2 feet outside the post. They win the battle. Achari down low, D to D, and watch this deflection. Way outside, and really just a tremendous deflection. No chance for Sorokin. If you're the defenseman, you've got to get a hold of Gensel's stick.
And for me, Butch, it starts a long time before that. What a beautiful deflection that was. Twice the New York Islanders defensemen, the puck on their stick, know how to deliver the puck into a spot that doesn't look dangerous, but certainly can be when you got guys like Jake Guentzel.
That timeout brought to you by your local Honda dealer. As here's a stretch pass on for Guentzel. He's got his third point of the period and his second goal. Two quick ones. The Penguins have opened up a 3-0 lead.
And after a timeout, Lane Lambert has got to be steaming mad. Quick pass up, and then Guentzel's on a breakaway. And Romanoff and Dobson, defenseman, well, got to think that was one of their men. And boy, oh boy, a breakaway from the blue line.
Penguins have the Islanders pinned.
Yeah, the Islanders, they can't get isolated man on man. The Penguins have done a good job of switching off and changing places.
Here's Balkin. Between the circles, he scores. And this sold-out crowd was getting frustrated, and that's the cherry on top. Four goals in this second period for Pittsburgh, Evgeny Malkin with that one.
I mean, they won all the races to the corners, and they moved the puck quickly, and they moved into the holes, and the Islanders just couldn't find a way. You can see players jumping around back and forth. And finally, Malkin's able to shake loose. So, again, that's all about communication and talking to one another. Watch Malkin come right through. Beautiful pass and makes no mistake.
Just way too much time for skilled players to make plays. And you see what happens. Just too much sitting back. And I know you're in a long shift.
All it is Sidney Crosby doesn't have a point yet. As it is Pedersen who leaves it for Evgeny Malkin. Pedersen to Letang, steps to it, instead of Holmstrom. Letang into the crease, they score. It's a 5-goal second period.
They have just owned the offensive zone on the New York Islanders in tonight's game. Dominated by the Penguins. I mean, look at the movement. Got to take these guys out. Too many turns around, and then good jump by Letang. And look at the positioning. Malkin's just all alone in front. I mean, you just got to do a better job. Let's watch where Aho goes. He's number 25. Watching, and he's on the outside, and not the good spot to be. And Malkin, who's so good, that pass goes right through the crease, but no chance for Sorokin.
Move it ahead, picks up speed as he goes, then Horvat for Barzell. Cross that one, broken up by Pustinen. He'll get it back on the lead pass from Letang. Pustinen up ice. Here's a 2-on-1. Pustinen has Zohorna. Fed it to the crease. It's jammed home. Zohorna. 6-0 Pittsburgh.
Rebound play, but it's a 2-on-1 by the Islanders, and there are going to be some guys tonight that are going to be -3, -4 as we watch this play. Zohorna goes to the net. First save by Sorokin, and the puck just bounces down, and Sorokin not quite strong enough, but a good play by Hawkins to get it all the way across. And it's just been involved in the game.
I can't say anyone's had a good night, but yeah, to your point, there's a lot of guys that had very poor nights.
Or what's the old thing? There's some passengers out there, Thomas.
Yeah.
There's a one-timer for Pustinen, and he's going to slam that in to make it 7-0. Valtteri Pustinen scores his first National Hockey League goal tonight.
The Islanders just haven't handled it. Look at all three Islanders down low on the left side, and that's just a shot from in a very, very good position. And again, Paul Arbov has, he's got to get all the way across, and that one-timer is just very, very good. But
here are the New York Islanders a couple of days after Christmas return from their holiday break. The sound of boos from their own fans. They lose to the Penguins 7-0, and it matches their worst home loss in franchise history.